lots, but my, at least my intuition is that there's a lot of references out there from this name that use the original authorship spelling. So, I don't know, I'll put it out to the room. What would you do in this case? Further investigation into taxonomic literature? So to look at the usage, let's... This has the potential to turn into the best or the worst live demonstration ever. Put that in there. Remember that in the extended format, I can link out into a search against the GBIF backbone taxonomy. Didn't come back with anything yet. What if I get rid of the option? Well, that's the name that comes from catalog of life, because that is the primary component of the GBIF backbone taxonomy, so no real surprise here. Anyways, I guess it highlights just how difficult it is to assess a list of taxonomic names. And at the very least, I've shown you two services that help you make sure that you have the correct format of your names and for plant names to assess misspellings, to resolve synonyms and choose the accepted name, and differentiate between spelling mistakes and qualifying names as well. So that's the end of that demonstration. I'm actually very happy that most of it worked out.
My question is on the authorship. In the such a confusion, would it be possible to go back to the original description of that species so that it can really be clarified what it is? HBQ or HB and total and academic and public work.
So the question is, how do I go back to my original identification? I'll put it to Javier or to John. Any ideas? So, your question related back to that name that I showed you, where there was a conflict in the author name, whether or not it was spelled C-U-I or T-S-U-I. And then I showed two different sources, one in Tropicos and then in the catalog of life. They were spelled differently. So the question is there one authoritative original identification official?
Literature search.